Und damit ein herzliches Willkommen unter Luzern weiter Part Let's Play Fakerate Order. Ich bin es, euer MC Muffix. Beim letzten Mal sind wir hier weiter in Agartha unterwegs gewesen. Nachdem wir in Eastman und dort von der Assassin of the Nightly City angegriffen wurden und diese hier die Fluttore sabotiert hat und die ganze Stadt überflutet wurde, ist möglicherweise Drake oder der Hut oder wie sie auch immer heißen mag, nun tot. Das heißt, eine der drei Städte ist im Endeffekt der drei Fraktionen hier ist schon besiegt. Aber wir wissen auch immer noch, dass der Berserk of Eldorado und die Assassin of the Nightless City immer noch unterwegs sind. Sie hat uns ja herausgefordert, dass wir sie finden sollen und mal besuchen sollen. Und ich würde mal sagen, genau das werden wir nun gleich mal machen. Jo, machen wir so. Also, dann würde ich sagen, legen wir los. Nur mit 6-8. The Brilliant Fortress City. Die Stadt, die niemals schläft. Viva Nightless City. Viva Nightless City. Irgendwie so, oder? Alright, this is as far as I go. Hä? Huh? You're not coming with us. I kept too many of my men back in the hideout when we infiltrated these. I don't want to repeat that mistake. If the resistance had been ready to attack from the outside when it started to sink, it would have been a hell of a kerfuffle, but we could still have saved some of the men there if only we'd been able to react accordingly. This time the resistance and I will stand by near the Nightless City. That way we can come in and take control of the city after you've taken down the assassin. Oh, wenn ich sterbe, während ich die Assassine down mache? Alternatively, we can storm the place on your signal if something unexpected happens like an ease. Either way, I'm afraid the resistance needs me to lead them, so I have to stay behind. I'm sorry to make you face all the danger yourself. It's okay. My friends here can handle anything. Phew. Huh. Well, that's reassuring. That's also one of Senpai's seven best qualities. He trusts his allies completely. Und was in meiner anderen Sekt? Komm, sag's mir alle, Mesh. And yet, something about working with this rider makes me uncomfortable. Why? May not know who he is, but he fought valiantly alongside us back in East. And there's no question that this is the best way of keeping Master safe. So then, why do I keep wishing he would stay somewhere I can keep an eye on him?
Weil ein alter Mann immer böse ist, das willst du doch nur damit sagen, oder? I might have said this before, but let me say it again. If you must accomplish something, never give up. No matter the difficulties, as long as you persevere, a way forward will eventually present itself. That may not mean much coming from a boring old man like me, but I can't help saying it anyway. You can never hear words of wisdom too often.
Okay, Maxi, do you have your smoke bombs? Good, then let's get started with our infiltration. As luck would have it, it's almost sundown. Never mind how strange the idea of sundown is several kilometers under the surface. At any rate, now should be a good time to scale the castle walls.
Dann infiltrieren wir nur die Stadt, die niemals schläft.
Ah, that's the brightest deserted ally I've ever seen in my life.
The city is certainly no less of a surprise than East. However, different.
Oh, coole Musik hier im Hintergrund.
It kind of reminds me of Shinjuku.
The Nightless City, a legendary place from Chinese myth, much like in East, was a legend from French myth. The original name in Chinese can also be translated as Nightless City. However, the word for a castle actually means the outer walls of the in Chinese. It's described in the Book of Han, but there aren't a lot of details about it. All we know is that the city was known for being very bright, even at nighttime. But given the image its name invokes, that expression came to be used for other cities that never sleep, like Shinjuku and Shanghai.
What about the assassin?
Unlike East, nobody knew much about who the Nightless City ruler was, or even if there was one at all. So I think it's entirely possible that the servants, that she's a servant with no relation to the city, who just happens to be using it for a base. Much like how Ryder using the peach gardeners is.
Good point. Whoever Ryder is, I kinda doubt he has much to do with the Chinese peach garden.
That said, the assassin who destroyed East did seem to have a Chinese air about her. No, I can't speculate when we still have no so little information.
Anyway, what's our next move? I believe we should learn from our mistake at ease. This time, we should take great pains to ensure this covered operation room is covered.
Ja. Wir können das nie machen.
As such, we should start by gathering information with as small as group as possible. Once we know more about the city itself, the threats we face and where to fight the assassins, then and only then do we all move in.
Yep, makes sense. I probably get lost in no time anyway.
Incidentally, Astaf and I will be the ones to go and get information.
Huh? Why me?
Remember, the citizens of the city we saw on the way here? As we suspected, the city is primarily inhabited by women. But unlike the pirates of East and the Amazons, these women are quite diverse in dress and race. The only thing they have in common is that they are all women. Therefore, as long as we keep our wits about us, the two of us should also be able to pass as citizens. Of course, if you insist, I'm willing to go alone.
That's too dangerous. You should go together.
True. Working as a team would let us deal with a much wider variety of challenges. Much as I am amused to working solo, this would undoubtedly be safer in case something goes wrong. What's more, here in the city full of women, you are the only member of this group who would not stand out walking besides me. Well, I suppose Master may be able to pass with the right outfit, but that is too great of a risk.
Das ist interessant, theoretisch hätten wir ein weiblicher Master sein können und dann müssten wir eigentlich locker durchgehen. Wenn man einen weiblichen Master spielt, dann gibt's diese Kampagne gar nicht, da kann man gar nicht skippen.
I'm the only one, huh? Gosh, when you put it like that. Okay, I'll do it. I was gonna let Dion handle the boring stuff and spend some quality time with Master here in the cellar.
Oh, verschwind.
But if you're that insistent, I'd be a disgrace to the draft policies of Charlemagne if I refused. Let's do this thing.
In that case, I'll have to remain here too. I may not be able to help gather information, but I will at least keep this area and Master secure. I'm young. I know, but I vow to protect Maxi and my life. Well, Kalia's staff needs to focus on monitoring Masters above all else. So if you two are going to go off on your own, I'm afraid we won't be able to offer any help from our end.
Not a problem. That's why we are going together. But what about the assassin of the Nightly City? She saw us back at ease. The other citizens here may not recognize you, but what will you do if she does?
A good point. We need some sort of disguise. That will not be a problem. Fortunately, I snuck into an empty house on the way here and borrowed two outfits from its closet. Naturally, I didn't have the luxury of choice in what I took, but since they were both hanging in the closet of a house belonging to an ordinary citizen, they should let us blend in well enough.
Nice phantom thief of the White Lady.
Just to remind you, Master, my title is Knight, not Thief.
So, is there one of these outfits for me?
Of course, that is why there are two of them. However, I only had time to base my selection on whether or not they would fit. So I don't wish to hear any complaints about how your outfit looks. Here, take it.
Ah, come on. Isn't it important to look good even in disguise? I mean, we don't want to get hauled in by the fashion police, do we? Oh well, guess I may wear a tritone.
Why are you changing here? Don't you realize Master's watching?
Puppy eyes. Fergus, gell?
At least change in the shadow here. Don't the 12 paladins have any sense of decency?
Well, I can't really say, as far as Roland concerned, but overall, I'd have to say nope.
That's nothing to be proud of. Come with me. I need to change as well.
Hey, where's the fire? I'm already naked anyway. Eep, my butt's got exposed like this.
Was the fuck?
Oh, Lavash. What are these outfits?
Ich dachte, du hast sie. Du weißt, welche Outfits du gestohlen hast.
Mein Sailor-Uniform.
Dion, didn't you choose this yourselves?
Wait, I don't know what to make of this either, Master. Please, don't look at me like that. I admit that I didn't look very closely when I took these outfits, so perhaps I shouldn't be surprised that it turned out to be like this.
Let me ask you this, exactly. What sort of room did you take this form?
From? Nothing special, just an ordinary bedroom with an ordinary chest of drawers.
Ah, bedroom, huh? Well then, I bet you can guess what these outfits were doing there, huh?
Turnman, I'm afraid I don't have time to go searching for different outfits now.
What's wrong with these? Far as I can tell, the only problem is that we are just damn cute.
I'm not certain that these outfits will fit in as you explore the city, but I'm certain that the other women here are dressed in all manner of ways. So given that...
Yes, that's true.
I've seen Western clothing, Japanese clothing, Chinese clothing and all manner of fashion ranging from medieval to modern times. In which case, perhaps we won't stand out too much after all.
Naja, Dion, ich glaube, das ist unmöglich. What's up, Mesh?
Oh, it's not a very big deal, but... Well, there's one thing I'd like to make sure of.
Whisper, whisper. Master, you're not sure of Dion's gender either, are you?
All I can say is Dion is Dion. Hätten wir doch schauen sollen, oder?
Right. So, given that, as much as I hate to ask you, but you're to do this, could you maybe take a look?
I think I see something there. Oh my god, das kommt mir viel zu anzüglich, Mann.
Me too, but of course, that doesn't prove anything, definitely. That's what makes Dion so mysterious. Perhaps your experts can use skills to alter their physical appearance, or perhaps... Well, that's the only option I can think of myself. I don't see a way to resolve this matter with any certainty. We could always ask, but I believe Dion would just smile and change the subject.
Not every mysterious needs to be solved.
Yes, I guess you're right. I'll do my best not to pay it any mind then.
Very well then, Astolfo. We shall have to undertake the mission dressed as we are. And please, keep your wits about you and do not draw undue attention.
Okay, I wonder if I'd look cuter with my skirt hiked up more.
There we go.
That's exactly what I was just talking about. Do not adjust your skirt as you walk. Do you want the world to see what's under your skirt?
Well, things certainly are quieter without those two around the R&D.
Schmeiß mal was Dolphus in der Party raus. Dion kann bleiben. Aber unser Auto fit schon sehr seltsam aussieht.
Still, that has required not a small amount of stealth and skill. I think it would be best if we just waited patiently for them to return.
A city populated entirely by women. To be honest, I'm finding this place a little disconcerting too. Though of course I make sure to do everything in my power to keep Maxi safe as necessary.
Still feeling out of place. The ally you we know would almost certainly be thrilled to be here. If anything, he'd hate the idea of waiting around doing nothing in a back alley when there's a whole city full of women right in front of him. Either that, or he'd be on the edge of a seat waiting for something exciting to happen. And I don't mean an enemy attack, although now that I think about it, I suppose a static warrior would find that exciting too, for very different reasons.
I see. So, what sort of exciting things would the Fergus you know be waiting for, if not an enemy attack?
A half-naked woman running away from a bad guy.
Exactly that sort of thing, Maxi. Even now, I can almost hear the other Fergus saying, "Well, isn't this my lucky day? Hers too.
That's awful. They really end up becoming a vulgar man obsessed with us more than sexual objects? No, that can't be right. I'm sure it turned out to be a proper warrior. She mentioned I would enjoy an enemy attack as well as that other thing. Still, I can't help but worry. I better get back to training. That'll get my mind off this stuff.
Ach, Fergus. Tut mir leid, dein Weg ist schon beschritten.
I think I'll start with some Celtic squats, like keeping an eye on our perimeter. Pardon me. Now you two have gone and made poor Fergus uneasy with all your teasing. Don't worry, Fergus. You always be you, no matter what else happens. Please, don't dwell on it. It's okay to just be yourself.
Thank you, Mesh.
Trotzdem wir erstmal hier ganz Zeit, Mann. Weiter, Mann.
But I will train whatever. I have to spare a moment. So this is me being myself. I see. You really do enjoy training, don't you?
I don't get the appeal at all myself.
Ja, ja. Du bist einfach ein untrainierter Master und tust dann nie, dass irgendwas besser wird.
I don't think I'd say it's appealing. It's more routine. I think it's really sort of separate from the things you do or fun or because you like them. For me, training is something I do because I have to. I don't know if there's anything more than to it than that. That said, I don't do nearly enough, which is why I'm still just a fledgling. But I can say that I know my stuff when it comes to more knowledge-oriented things. The druids who teach me are actually afraid of me now, since I learn everything they teach me so quickly that they keep running out of material. They say that if they let me, I'd end up making them talk all day, every day, from morning till tonight. Wow, you really can judge a book by its cover. I guess everyone really does have their own backstory. That goes for other servants too. Of course this has been a good reminder of that. Every one of them lived a full life and achieved something great as a hero. Their past must have been very precious to them. Fergus, Astolfadion, Galahad, who entrusted me with his power. They all had their own lives lived before they become heroes. I'd love to hear more about them someday.
Yeah? If you really give it some thought, it makes sense. Of course there were experts written about in legends and myth would have led to multiple lives. And since, by definition, their stories were exciting enough to pass on their future generation, there's not a boring one to be found in the bunch.
Right, so Fergus, please don't feel as if you have to force yourself to do anything. No matter what else may happen, as long as you remain yourself, you become who you're meant to be. Does that mean I'm doomed to become a man obsessed with the desire for women? That's terrible!
Mesh, du hast alles kaputt gemacht. Jetzt muss er noch härter trainieren.
No, sorry, I didn't mean it like that. I just meant to you to become a strong, charming warrior. I do take issue with some of your future self more overtly harassing comments. But you still grow up to be a great man, almost like everyone's dependable uncle, huh? Sorry, I'm afraid I mistook the sound of a breathing Fergus. There's some heavy breathing approaching you now at what appears to be running speed.
Heavy breathing? Could it be a half-naked woman after all?
It's a dog. Thank goodness, yes. I'm geniusly glad that's what it turned out to be. Though that's not to say that I'm in favor of letting dogs run around without a leash. Be careful, it appears to be hungry.
Ihr seid alle so schlecht, man. Ihr seid alle so schlecht, man. Okay, liebe Leute, dann machen wir mal die leider nicht nackte Frau fertig. Oi, mein Gott, auch diese seltsame Stadt. Da ist irgend sowas in mir, in der Region, die tut mir nicht gut in der Nase. Oh, ist das nicht ein süßes Hündchen? Oh. Süßes Hündchen. Für die, die es übrigens interessiert, das ist die Kombination, mit der man Barbatos insta-killen kann. Oh nee, verdammt, nee, ist es nicht. Ich hätte Mecha Ellie nehmen sollen, fällt mir gerade auf. Dumm. Egal. Machen wir es in zwei Zügen. So. Egal, haben wir Marta dabei. So, denn ich habe jetzt meine eigene Waver, gell? Und er ist natürlich im Anzug, gell? Weil wenn die Frauen kommen, dann muss er im Anzug kommen. Zum Glück hatte ich meine Party hier noch aus. Ja, verdammt, Mann. Meine Party hatte ich hier noch von meinem Raid-Boss hier. Also komm. Wird es kein Insta-Kill, schade. Aber ist auch nicht so schlimm. Verdammt, Mann, ich hätte Mekka-Ellie anstatt Martha nehmen sollen. Dann wäre es sicher gegangen, aber das war eigentlich die sichere Party. Aber der Barbot hat halt immer so einen blöden Debuff gemacht. Ey, wurscht. So, jetzt kommt's. Damit ja auch unsere gute verdammt, nicht Mekka-Ellie, Sandan hätte ich nehmen müssen. Damit auch unsere kleine Dame hier mal Schaden macht.
Vindetta Fire!
So, Gurkenschaden. Oh, richtig schlecht. So, jetzt haut's aber mal rauf hier, Mann. Ah! Arme Marta. Arme Marta. Aber du kannst mich nicht stoppen. So, und jetzt bitte beende sie dir. Na, das wird dann lang. 57.000 mal in 100 Jahren nicht mit dir. Schlecht, Mann. Zum Glück lief es nicht ganz so schlecht bei Barbatos. Ah! Keine Martha tot. Nein! Oh, Martha hat's überlebt. So, liebe Leute. Und Vega muss einfach nur mal mit dem Finger schnipsen und die Gegner sind down. Schau ich an. Ein Finger schnipsen und der Gegner ist down, Mann. Ja, okay. Kein Insta-Kill, aber in Ordnung. Schäme ich mich gerade dafür. Beim Barbatos Raid ging das viel besser. So, dann würde ich sagen, machen wir hier einfach mal weiter. So wie es aussieht, haben wir doch noch das ein oder andere Problem und die mit den wild gewordenen Hunden, da haben wir doch schon mal was gehört darüber.
Hier, gleich der Zauberwurf. Well, those things seem to be a dogs, technically anyway. Perhaps those were some of the dog riders was talking about.
I don't think we are getting off that easy.
By the way, is everything okay there? Everything's happened so suddenly that I have trouble to imagine you could have kept quiet. To say nothing of how noisy combat usually is, even in a deserted back alley like this, there's a chance that someone may have... There! I can hear breathing or footsteps again, and it don't belong to animal this time.
Could it be?
Crap, I forgot to feed him. Where could I have gone?
Oh man, this is bad, really bad. When those things get hungry, they go around eating other men. I think I heard something off this way.
So it was a fully clothed man. Well, I'm glad it turned out that way too.
What the? They're dead! Who are you people? Wait, you're not subjects of the Nightly City, are you?
You seem to be alone. That's lucky. You were taken from the surface? We are allied with the resistance that's trying to free the unsafe men. Maybe you've heard of them.
Uh-oh. Es ist niemals gut zu sagen, dass man vom Widerstand ist.
If you help us, we may be able to rescue the man here in the Nightly City as...
Stop! Stop! No, it's not a good time. If I heard you, they must have heard you too. Which means it's only a matter of time until they come looking to see what happened. Oh god, what am I going to do? They're coming with their bullocks and hammers. The merciless executioner will be here soon.
Aber es ist doch niemals gut, einfach zu sagen, okay, ich könnte Widerstand, alles ist tutti frutti. So, dala, liebe Leute, dann würde ich sagen, machen wir doch jetzt erstmal einen kleinen Cut und beim nächsten Mal geht es dann hier weiter mit Let's Play Fake und Ora. Dann würde ich sagen, schauen wir mal, wer da wirklich kommt. Bis dann, auf Wiedersehen.